31, we had a question coming out of section 6.1, number 65. And this was asking us to do one of those finance questions. And it was saying, hey, how much principal will Jamal need so that he has $54,000 in 5 years? Now, if we go back to exercise 33, we solved for the principal equation. So we can just plug in our numbers, right? We know the amount that he's going to need in 5 years is $54,000. We know the interest rate as a decimal is 0.082. If it's compounding daily, we know that we get interest 365 days a year. And it says in there that we need 5 years. So you could plug all of those in and you could get that number. Now, I just want to go through it. I would say probably a more straightforward way if I hadn't solved for P in number 33. So here's what I mean. Usually when I run these problems, I just write my interest formula, 1 plus R over N to the NT, and then I start plugging away. So Jamal wants 54,000, right, in 5 years. He doesn't know how much he needs now. He doesn't know his principal. We know the interest rate is 0.082. Apparently he's going to get interest every day. Good for him. I wish I had that account. And he wants to put it in there for 5 years. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to find this number on my calculator and this one and just simplify this equation a little bit. So I'm going to have $54,000 is going to equal P times. Now, when I crunched the 1 plus 0.082 divided by 365, I get 1.000225. I would recommend saving as many decimal places as you can. I actually just save all the decimal places in my calculator. Because especially with these money problems and exponential growth, as soon as you round off a number at a like maybe halfway through the problem, your end answer won't be as accurate. 365 times 5 is 1825. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to crunch this number on my calculator. So I'll take that previous answer I got and raise it to the 1825th power. And when I do that, I'm looking at 54,000. Is going to equal P times, this wound up being about 1.507. All right, and again, I kept all of the decimals through here. So I want to be real clear that I'm only writing three decimals at this step, but I kept all of them in my calculator. And then when I divide by 1.507, I will find that principal. And sure enough, if you float all of your decimal places, you do wind up getting that he needs $35,838.76 now, so that in 5 years, he can have $54,000. All right. Thanks so much, everyone. Bye.